Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to our next online assembly on Friday, the 22nd of January. I hope you're all well. I have been so impressed when I've been seeing the work you've been putting onto Seesaw and talking to your teachers about what you've been achieving from home this week. So well done, everybody, and keep up the good work. So I asked your teachers to tell me children that have made them particularly proud. Maybe you've been showing our school values of ambitious, resilient and kind. Maybe you've just been working exceptionally hard and your teachers want to celebrate you this week. So I have got such a long list. You won't believe how many children I've been sent and the detailed reasons your teachers want to celebrate you. And that makes me really proud. So well done, everybody. It just goes to show you don't have to be in the school building to work super hard. So let me see who we're going to be celebrating. I'm just going to turn the sound off on my laptop. So I'm going to start with nursery. Miss Green has sent me these names through, and the children we are celebrating from nursery this week are, drum roll please, Ifra Mahmood from Nursery Zephaniah. She's been in every single live meeting and uploading her work to Seesaw every single day. Even though she's been poorly with a dislocated collarbone, Mum's been trying really, really hard to support her as well. My goodness, that's fantastic. Such dedication. Well done, Ifra. That is fantastic. Keep that up. And then we've got Azair Ali from Nursery Cadbury for engaging with Seesaw and live meetings every day. He goes above and beyond with his work, and every time a comment is left by his teacher, he responds with a voice note. So he records a message so that Miss Green can listen to that back. Well done to our children in nursery who are working super hard. You are going to get a certificate come to your house in the post that you can put up to show just how pleased we are with everything you've been doing. Well done, nursery, isn't that fantastic? So if the children in nursery can do this, that just goes to show that everybody can be working really hard in all our different year groups. Now, Mrs. Abba said it was very difficult to choose from reception because the children have been working so hard, but they have chosen somebody from each class. And this week from reception, what? We've got Mariam Sajid. Mariam is working extremely hard, completing all the activities set on Seesaw, eagerly attending all the live meetings and recording mini videos of what she's been doing. Maybe you could help me, Mariam. I'm not very good for videos. And sending them. And Mariam asks Mrs. Abbas when she's going to return to school because she knows that she's missing all of her friends. So she wants to say a huge well done to Mariam and her mum for completing all the work on time and being really positive. Oh, well done, Mariam. That's amazing. And hopefully it won't be too long before we're all back at school together. You'll get a certificate in the post. What a superstar. And from Reception Simmons, we've got Issa Ali, working so hard at home with his mum, trying his best to complete all four activities every day with a real improvement in counting skills. Well done. Keep that up. That is fantastic. And then from Reception Tolkien, Ishmael Adnan, completing every piece of work to a really high standard and extending work in all areas, so doing some challenge work as well, and attending AM and PM meetings and very dedicated to his learning. Well done. That's absolutely fantastic. Our children in the early years who are really, really trying their best, attending the live meetings, uploading their work on Seesaw and being really positive when they're working from home. And thank you to all the parents for their support as well. A big clap to our children in reception. That is amazing. Well done. Moving on to year one. Let's see who we're celebrating there. From one Tolkien, we've got Umair Ahmed for a really positive attitude to his work. Well done, Umair. Fantastic. From one Watt, Issa Zaman showing great persistence in completing all his work to a high standard, so never giving up. Well done, Issa. From one Simmons, Amiza Hasbullah for reading every day and recording it on Seesaw. Fantastic. You can record yourself reading so your teacher can hear you. That's absolutely brilliant. They love listening to you read. And from one Cadbury, we've got Amina Ali for smiling in every live meeting, completing all her work to a very high standard. Your teachers love seeing your smiling faces in the mornings and the afternoons. It brightens up their day. Fantastic. And Miss Brinkworth said she'd really like to say just how impressed they've been with year one in general, working incredibly hard and making their teachers proud. So all the children in year one, well done. But particularly well done to those four children. You will also be getting your certificates in the post. Fantastic. And then in year two, we've got one special mention in year two. Miss Rani sent this one, and even in her email, she put in the drum roll. So we're ready this week. It has to be Sarah from Two Tolkien. She's been in every live meeting, completing work to a high standard, watching all the videos the teachers have been recording, just like she does in school, and taking feedback on board. She's completing the math challenges with Mr. Bevan, that he sets in his videos and producing some brilliant writing. She's working just as hard as she would be in school. And Miss Ryan sent me some pictures of her work and it looks absolutely fantastic. The quality of the work here, beautiful handwriting, really lovely neat diagrams to help with the maths work. I'm very impressed with that. Well done, Sarah. What a superstar. All of our children in early years and key stage one have been doing absolutely fantastically. And we know how tricky it is when you're working from home. So thank you and well done. And well done to anybody who's helping you at home as well. Might be mums or dads or older brothers and sisters, because it's really making a big difference. So well done. I'm going to do my story and then we'll come back and see who we're celebrating in key stage two this week. And the story this week, I thought I'd give us something that was a little bit, maybe a little bit different, not a picture book this week. So I asked Jude and he let me know which books he thought I should choose. And this is one of his favourites. Charlie Changes Into a Chicken. It's very funny. In fact, he liked it so much that for Christmas, he asked for some more of the books and he's now got Charlie Turns Into a T-Rex and Charlie Morphs Into a Mammoth. And they're some of his favourite books. So he's in year three, so he can read his books to himself. But if you're a bit younger, maybe somebody could read it to you. Or if you're a bit older, you might just enjoy it. Very funny. And they're all about a boy called Charlie. I'll read you the back, the blurb, so we can see what's going to happen. Charlie McGuffin has an incredible secret. He can change into animals. All sorts of animals, in fact. A flea, a pigeon, even a rhino. The trouble is, it only happens when he gets worried. And right now, Charlie has quite a lot to worry about. His brother who's in hospital, his parents who are panicking, and the school bully who has Charlie in his sights. But with the help of his three best friends, Charlie needs to find a way to deal with his crazy new power, and fast. Can you imagine that? If when you got a bit worried, you turned into a different animal. My goodness me. Be a bit strange, wouldn't it? I'm just going to read you a little bit from one of the chapters when Charlie first turns into a different animal. So he's been to visit his big brother who's in hospital, who's a bit poorly. And downstairs he can hear his parents who are arguing because they're very worried about his big brother. And this is what happens. It was there and then that it first happened. It began with a twitching in his eye. Charlie froze to the spot, feeling his eyelid blink manically. His eye had twitched before when he'd been tired, but this felt different somehow. It felt like somebody had just plugged him into a wall socket. The twitching spread to his other eye and both eyes were blinking and twitching. A feeling burst through his whole body, like he'd been shot through an electrical wire, like he was the electricity. Every part of his body fizzed and hummed, and the fizzing and humming became stronger until he felt like he was on fire, but a fire inside a never-ending tube squeezing and vibrating. His skin felt extraordinary, alive. He looked at his arm and with some considerable alarm saw that hair was sprouting out of every part of his skin. And weirdly, the room was growing larger too. But no, Charlie realised, the room wasn't growing larger. It was him who was shrinking. Smaller and smaller and smaller he shrank, the room growing even larger around him. And his body, Charlie hardly dared look, his body was transforming. Completely. Extra legs were growing out of him, which is every bit as gross as you can imagine. And finally, he felt new eyes emerging out of his head, which was possibly even grosser than the new legs. Charlie recognised almost immediately that he was turning into a spider. And how did Charlie know this? He looked at the evidence. Evidence one. Charlie was now tiny. Admittedly, he hadn't been that big before he changed, but he could see a dried apricot under his bed that he'd been saving for a rainy day, and he was now about the same size as an apricot, about this big. And normal 9-year-old boys usually aren't the size of dried apricots. Evidence two. Charlie counted his legs. And he had 8 of them, which is about 6 too many legs for a human, but just the right number for a spider. Evidence three. He was completely covered in short brown hair. Now, being covered in hair doesn't necessarily stop someone from being human. Take Charlie's Uncle Pete, for instance. But let's have a little look at this picture. Can you see the spider here? How many eyes has the spider got? I wonder if you can do a little bit of research and see if you can find out. We all know spiders have got 8 legs, but how many eyes has a spider got? So, what happens to Charlie when he gets really worried is he turns into a different animal. In this case, the first time he's turned into a spider. Now, I think at the moment, probably we all feel a little bit worried sometimes because this is a bit of a different situation. We're at home, We can't go to school, we can't see our family, we can't go to the shops and do all the things we'd normally do. So sometimes we have a bit more time to be worried, and maybe we're worried about our family or people becoming poorly, and that's perfectly normal. And thank goodness we don't turn into a different animal when we get worried. But it is good for us to think of ways to feel better. So in the book, because I've read the book and I won't give anything away, when Charlie feels worried, he just tries to think about things to make him happy and take his mind off it. And when he thinks about those happy things, it sometimes stops him from turning into a different animal. So I thought today, our activity that followed our assembly could be at you thinking about, what would you think about to stop you from worrying? Something you can think about that makes you really happy. So you might think about your favourite place to go. Maybe that's going to the park and playing football. Maybe it's going to visit your grandparents. Maybe it's going shopping. You might be going to school and seeing all your friends and playing in the playground. Or you could think about things that you like to do or things that make you happy. Reading a book, watching a film, spending time with your friends. And what would be really fantastic is if you could draw me a picture of what it is that you really like that makes you happy. And what would you think about to stop you turning into a different animal when you were worried, and to help take your mind off anything you might be worried about at the moment? So June and Martha did something a little bit similar, that's my children, when they were at school, and they made them into calendars. So this is Martha's. She's done hers in the style of an artist called Maria Rivens. And if you see here, is she has to put all the things that she thinks about that make her happy. So the things that Martha thinks about are, she loves nature and she loves animals. So you can see she's got on here the fox, and she's got some flowers. So one of the things that Martha really likes to do if she's feeling a bit worried is to go to the park and have a walk around to see if we can see spot any squirrels or look for different flowers. Sometimes we collect them and we do some artwork with them. She's also put on a little badge. This is her school that she goes to. That's a school badge because she loves going to school and spending time with her friends. She's put a football here, and I think that might be because her big brother Jude really likes football, and sometimes she likes to play football with Jude as well. And she has put on here, let's see what else she's put on here. She's put on a car, so maybe she likes it when we go on our car journeys. Maybe if we're going on holiday on a car journey. So she's put on here, she's drawn all the things. Well, actually, she's cut out pictures of hers, all the things that she really likes to do. So what you could do at home is you could draw yourself, or if you've got a photo, you could stick a photo on. And then you could draw the things that make you happy that you would think about. Or you could cut them out like Martha's done and stick them on. Or Jude did his a little bit differently. So as I said, he's a big football fan, a big Aston Villa fan. Not sure if we've got any more Aston Villa fans out there. And he did some artwork. So he had his photo of him in his football kit. And then he painted, in fact, the other half of that. So you could do something a little bit different. If football is what you would think about to take your mind off the things you were worried about, you could just take a photo of you or draw you and then do a thought bubble on you playing football with your friends. Or you could have a go and do a picture a bit like that. So it would be really lovely if I could see you uploading onto Seesaw a picture or something to show me what you would think about to stop you from being worried. And thank you to those children who put some fantastic artwork from the last assembly onto their Seesaw or sent them to their teacher. And I would like to give a special shout out to Mustafa from 3 Cadbury. I absolutely loved your picture of the fox and the leaves. It was very similar to the one we did. Absolutely beautiful. Well done and thank you. Right. And on with our celebrations and on to Key Stage 2, starting with Year 3. Let's see who we're celebrating in Year 3. From 3, what we've got? Daniel Alley. Daniel is always in live meetings. He does all his home learning and submits his work every single day. He tries his absolute best and always responds to the feedback. He even sent a video of him doing the PE lesson. I think Mr. Gibb and Mr. Keane would like to see that. Very positive and smiling whenever I speak to him, which is lovely. Keep it up, Daniel. Absolutely fantastic. Sounds like the model student working from home. Well done. In 3 Zephaniah, we've got Dean Mahmood for consistently outstanding work and being a star on Seesaw. Well done, Dean. Keep that up. That's amazing. Oh, 3 Cadbury. Mustafa, you've got your second shout out. One from me and one from Miss Hussein. Completing all your activities on Seesaw to an amazingly high standard. And any feedback given, whether it's something he needs to look at or a challenge, he responds to you straight away. He's also super kind and always thanks Mrs. Hussein for looking at his work and helping. Thank you, Mustafa. Well done. That's amazing. Keep that up. And then in 3 Simmons, we've got Arbab. Every day she will do her work and put it on Seesaw. She will respond to feedback and ask for help when she's not sure. And she always gives her best in what she does. And her work is very neat and clear for the teacher to see and to give feedback. That's absolutely fantastic, Miss Shunker. Must be very impressed with that. Well done to the children in Year 3. Super proud of you. Well done. It's quite hard doing assembly when there's not lots of children to join in with the clapping. Can't wait until we can all be back in our school hall and I can see you and I can shake your hand and give you your certificates. I'm really missing doing that. Let's have a look from year four. Oh goodness me, four Tolkien. We've got two people, A.R. Mahmood and Zayad Khan, attending live lessons, doing all the work on time to a high quality and responding to feedback given by the teacher. That sounds to me like the three things that we really want you to be doing at the moment. So well done. In four Yusef's eye, we've got Anaiba Khan for showing resilience while completing our activities on Seesaw. Your work has shown real improvement with every activity because you keep on trying your best. Well done, that's fantastic. And then in four Cadbury, we've got Amelia for showing resilience as well while completing her activities on Seesaw. Amelia Taswar, well done, Amelia, and well done to children in year four. I would like to hear that all the children are attending your live lessons and you're doing your work to a really good standard, just like you would in school, and that you are responding to the feedback your teacher is giving you. That would be absolutely brilliant and it would make all of the teachers and me very happy. Well done, year four. In year five, we've got Husna from Five Simmons, who's producing brilliant quality work on Seesaw every day. Mr. Ledingham's been very impressed with how eager she is to contribute to discussions, and she's taken responsibility to ask for help when she needs it, which is even more important when you're learning remotely. Absolutely. It's so much harder when your teacher's not in the classroom with you, so do ask for help if you need it. Well done, Husna. That sounds like very mature attitude to home learning. From Five Tolkien, we've got Zayan Shah, who's been working incredibly hard and the quality of his work is really, really good. Well done, Zayan. It's evident he's putting a lot of time and effort in. He's always attending the live meetings and he's completing the activities on Seesaw daily and will also ask for help and respond to feedback given in live lessons. So Miss Khan is very impressed with the progress you are making and super proud of you as well. So well done, Zayan. That's amazing. And then in Five Yusef's side, we've got Jamal Hutchinson. Well done, Jamal. He's been active on Seesaw every single day. That is brilliant. Keep that up. Completing his work in a timely manner and always responding positively to the comments given. He has been very proactive with his learning. He is motivated and determined. Even if we are doing the work remotely, he's still working just as hard as he would in class. So well done, Jamal. Making the Spitzalides very, very proud of you there. And last but not least, from Five Zephaniah, we've got Adiba Ali, who's been consistently producing high quality work on Seesaw, just like she would as if we were in school. And this is what's making me very happy to hear this. Always responding to feedback and trying to improve where she can, meeting the high expectations we have at school, doing an incredible job. Incredible, what a fantastic word to use there. Incredible word from Miss Begum there. Keep it up, Adiba, well done. And well done, year five. I'm really impressed. And I'm really excited that from next week, year five, we're going to be having one of our live lessons starting next week with their maths lesson. I can't wait to see you all enjoying those lessons with your teachers. I know your teachers are very excited too. And then, oh, I think year five deserve a round of applause. And then last but not least, we've now got our year sixes. Let's see who we're celebrating. Oh, I think this might be a family affair this week because we've got Amina from 6S, so Mustafa's sister, chosen Amina because she has shown her true potential while working at home, exceeding expectations, completing every piece of work to the best of her ability, using the correct punctuation where necessary and always putting in 100%. Amina will also edit her work using green font, which is fantastic, just like using a green pen at school. And her manners make Miss Iqbal very happy. It's always a pleasure when she receives her work on Seesaw. Well done, it's absolutely amazing. Miss Naya has chosen Issa Mahmood from 6 Cadbury for actively engaging in all the lessons, having all of his equipment ready in the morning, listening attentively to live lessons and completing work to a high standard. We are very proud of how well he's adapted to his new way of learning. So Miss Davin and Miss Naya, I think, say, well done, Issa, that's fantastic. Well done, Year 6. Really proud of you. And then we've got Arman Khan from 6 Watt, who's trying super hard every day to complete work to a good standard. Well done, Arman. Putting in a real effort there. We have got from 6 Zephaniah for being super ambitious. Miss Wister has chosen Mutaha Bibi. Mutaha is putting 100% into all of her work on Seesaw, submitting every piece to a high standard. I really like to hear that. Responding promptly to feedback, enabling her to learn from mistakes and challenge herself to reach the next level of her subjects. A fantastic start to home learning. Well done. Oh, and then 6 Tolkien, Mr. Yule, last but not least, just having a look here. Mr. Yule, as always, finding it very hard to choose. And he's going to go with Faiza Hussein, being super engaged with every online lesson and activity. She's also one of the only ones brave enough to have her camera on. She's been really helpful telling and showing Mr. Yule when he's muted or showing the wrong screen. A wonderful technical assistant. I could definitely use some help with that as well, Pfizer. And Mr. Yule's got one special message for Year 6, and he says, please put your cameras on in your live meetings and your lessons. They really, really, your teachers want to see your faces. And it's much better to be able to engage and feel like you're taking part in a lesson if everybody can see each other. So please put your cameras on. That's a plea there from Mr. Yule. Please put those cameras on, Year 6. But well done. Absolutely fantastic. I am so proud of all of you. It's such a different way of working, but you have adapted so well. You have been continuing, I can hear, to be incredibly ambitious, completing your work to the best of your ability, making sure you respond to feedback and giving yourselves those challenges and asking for help if you need it. You've been very resilient. Not giving up, not thinking, I can't do this, it's too difficult. But you know what? Don't worry if you feel like that some days. That's okay. Just start again the next day. And being kind. Being kind and smiling and helping your teachers and asking how they are and saying thank you for the work they're putting in for you. And I hope you're being kind, and I'm sure you are, to your family and your friends and the people that you're seeing when you're at home. And just make sure that you keep that up and make sure that you look after yourselves and that you and your family stay safe and well. Already I'm excited to see who we're going to be celebrating next week. And all those children we've mentioned today, don't forget, you will get those certificates coming to you through your letterbox. They'll be posted out to you next week, so you can keep those certificates and celebrate the really fantastic achievement that they are. So well done, everybody, and I look forward to seeing you next week. Take care.